Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Nova Iron Galaxy on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Nova Iron Galaxy and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Nova Iron Galaxy. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all mates, to start we need to launch our favorite internet browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to that URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type it, because there's the clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed right here on our own internet site of Usitility, at which we have a nice meticulous demonstration on the way to download and install Nova Iron Galaxy on computer. We scroll down a tad and press on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will run to play Nova Iron Galaxy on our PC. As you can discover here, we have several pros of preferring using that emulator. Now we will start downloading the Nova Iron Galaxy by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green color. We then click on it. And the download action takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It's a file we have to execute. The following step is to run the executable file, okay, then we need to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the system. We clicked yes. I minimize the browser to start to see the installation software better. The installer is very simple to use. It is made up of two possibilities, install and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path genuinely does. We only simply click on it. And now we observe that we got here the path where in fact the emulator can be put in. If we would you like to change for better this folder we are required to click on the browse button, therefore we opt for another folder and set up the emulator where we would like. I prefer to leave it by default. I click on back, so I simply click on install. Voila, the installation commences and it's going to progress together with the download of all these MB which are shown on that screen. The time you save it on your machine, it is likely to be more or less megabytes. The download speed will go faster or slower, depending on your type of access to the web and depending on the speed of the emulator servers. Today they're working rather fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has been started immediately. As you can observe, down here, we have a progress bar which will fill up when it has reached the ending, the emulator can be started for the first time. The truth is the emulator was already started, here for the very first time. Before we carry on, as you can observe, it created two app icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is definitely the only one we are considering. The moment we would like to start Nova Iron Galaxy on the PC, we double mouse click on this icon and run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we perform the next phase, which is actually a must-have, and that's to visit the Google Play Store. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can observe the Google Play is launched. In this case we must log on. At this point as soon as we're right here, we must definitely begin doing this next phase that is absolutely mandatory. Therefore we click on Sign In. At this moment it says Checking Info. It might in some cases get stopped at Checking Info, and so it fails to continue. If that's the case, you could attempt to connect to your account after a number of hours but it will surely usually be sorted out. At this moment we will type our email and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For example you may use the same exact email you're using currently in your YouTube account. Therefore I will enter my information and I will go back as soon as I have done it. That's it, details typed. Below is Google welcoming us and presenting us the twos. We must approve them all simply by clicking on I agree. Following, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You might keep it checked and this will generate a backup of your data on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can utilize this option if you like. We click Accept. Google Play Store is launched without need to open it manually and immediately. To set up the app, we would need to get to the Android emulator desktop by double-clicking on this icon indicated green-colored. Right now that we are watching the desktop of that Android emulator, we can see that we come with there the Install App Game option. We click or double-click on the button. There we get the Android game. Let's quickly mouse-click there on the Install choice that I'm just showing now in green color. And this will begin the software setup. At this time it is going to download and install the Android game, it could take a bit of time or it could be almost immediate. It again all is subject to on our own internet connection. It has just finished installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by hitting the following option I'm presenting in green, if you want to use Nova Iron Galaxy for the first time. We're by now on the emulator desktop, and then we are on the way to mouse click on the fresh Nova Iron Galaxy app icon which was created. This video game is started for the first time. So there we get it, I am able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the sound level of this emulator. This is here, we use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we should activate the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. This is the very first one, we simply click on that software icon which I'm identifying in green color. And the screen is maximized, experiencing one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. In the event that we really want to play the app using all the screen, we select that software icon. Then we would without a doubt be experiencing the Android game in full screen function. To stop the 100% screen functionality, push the F11 key. And we'd currently end up being in standard computer screen setting. At present, I am starting to explain you the keys mapping and that is really surprisingly useful. That step we will certainly be able to play the game application far more effortlessly. The first thing is to press this keyboard icon. And here you will be able to complete the appropriate controls. I'm going to let the normal settings, though if you prefer to change this, you may very well do so without having problem. Clearly, the emulator is totally in our own language. Occasionally it occurs that the emulator is presented in the erroneous language, for instance, in Mandarin. And therefore to set it in the appropriate language we click here to the cogwheel. Then here throughout various other controls, we just click on the language drop down. We are able to determine the language we prefer, German, Chinese, etc. As soon as the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator will restart, and the Android game, the next time we run it, would of course be in the chosen language. At this point, there's another thing that we need to take into consideration, and it's that we will get a message from Google telling that a different machine has been connected to this Google account. It will likely check with us if we're the ones who have connected that electronic device. Yes, we shouldn't worry, considering the fact that emulator is emulating an Android electronic device. In order to discover which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we come back here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. And so we go here to the model selection. And there we realize that the emulator is acting as a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for my video tutorial. I sincerely hope you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was interesting. If that's the case, give it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and I will be happy to answer all your comments, questions or ideas, leave them in the comment box below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams every once in a while, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click any of the instructional videos that happens to be showing up on the list of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the upcoming video game videos. Bye.